As the bridge between where university meets sport, FISU is in a unique position to shape young lives and impact futures. FISU's vision is a world where leaders are positively influenced by the university experience. And it's for this reason that FISU is launching the Healthy Campus program globally tomorrow. The heart of this Healthy Campus program is built on the experiences of 30 worldwide experts that specialize in distinct areas of student health and well-being. The knowledge from these experts is shared on a bespoke platform. This makes for an unprecedented global network that combines the best practices, cutting-edge theories, as well as a forum for the universities to share their successes. Leading this program is FISU Healthy Campus Director Fernando Parente. As a former FISU Executive Committee member, who was also named Portugal's Sports Manager of the Year in 2017, we're lucky to have Fernando joining us to give us the inside scoop into what's happening with the FISU Healthy Campus program. So, without further ado, let's check in with Fernando and see what he has to say during this live interview. All right, we're waiting for Fernando. Hey, Fernando. Hey, great to see you.
Great to see you too, Torres.
Yeah. So, I mean, we have the global launch of the FISU Healthy Campus program coming tomorrow. That's tomorrow morning. So we only have a couple hours. So how much sleep are you planning on getting in the next over tonight?
Well, first of all, I would like to say hello to everyone who is watching this conversation, and I hope that that all are really well in good health. Regarding your question, usually I don't sleep many hours. I think I'm not nervous, a little bit anxious, because it will be an important day for all of us in FISU also. And we had many months of work, complex work, but also with the motivation given by our executive committee, our president, our secretary general, all our colleagues from the staff, and the help that we had from the 7 pilot universities from the 5 continents, and of course from around 30 international really experts that help us to design this program. So with that, it gives us some tranquility. We can say I will be more nervous maybe if you speak too fast, because normally you speak too fast, and don't make me nervous, please.
I'll work on it, Fernando. I'll work on it. So one thing you mentioned is the 7 pilot universities. So this is pretty cool that you've already had universities signed up for the Healthy Campus program before it has even launched. So what are these elite 7 universities saying about why they want to be part of this program? How are they liking the experience so far?
Well, yes, there are many universities that are working very well in the many domains, in many areas of well-being. What did not exist until now is a common reference for the global approach of the well-being. In addition to the issue, FISU wants that universities learn from each other. So it's also a global benchmarking project. We can say that this is crucial for to have more and more people involved in the program, and also for the local development inside each campus, and also for innovation. The visit that we made to the 7 pilot universities from 5 different continents, the meetings that we had with the rectors and the teams in charge of Healthy Campus domains, help us to understand better the needs and also to watch locally good practices and how to integrate all this information in our guidelines, in our standard document.
Yeah, and when people probably think of FISU, one thing they definitely think about is sports. I mean, we have the World University Games, World University Championships, University World Cups. You know, these events get 10,000, 20,000 people each year participating. But now we're kind of, I mean, and we've always had educational events where, like the FISU World Forum, the World Conference, where we've definitely looked at dual career. But now the university sports community is really turning its attention to enhancing the health and wellness of the entire student body. So why is this the perfect time to do something like that?
Well, it's true. It's true that elite sport competitions are normally, and in FISU it's the same, are the most visible face of one organization, international organization like us. But FISU have been, in fact, developing, as you said, an interesting work with some promotional and educational events. Of course, this project, Healthy Campus, will be more visible to FISU policy and to FISU programs by our grassroots, by our campus community. But let's say that according to our constitution, I think is in the article number 2, FISU said to us that FISU has a mission to act for the health and well-being of the students. So we are focused on that in a global project, not only for elite sport, but also for sports and well-being for all. In that sense, we also count on the excellent work of the FISU Association member, the National University Sports Federations, for the development of this program, because they will be really important because they are our heart inside each country.
Yeah, and so as you mentioned, you mentioned about the grassroots, you know, the international, you know, community that the FISU already has with the member associations, continental associations, relationships with the universities. So what is it about FISU and the university sport community that makes it so well positioned to take the lead on a project like this?
Well, FISU is an international organization with members in almost 180 different countries and regions. It's a global organization that promotes physical activity, sports, well-being, and in academic life, of course, combining with studies, everything together. FISU already has this general idea of developing this program. As Eric Santron said here in his interview, and he said already a few times, the fact that FISU had its quarters on the campus, it was mentioned by Eric, was decisive to the development of this program, because now the headquarters of FISU are inside the campus, so we feel more the environment of the campus. By other hand, FISU also has a long tradition in relationship with international stakeholders from world of sport and also higher education, which gives us a perfect position to launch this program. I think FISU is unique and is the right international organization to launch a program like that.
Thanks, Fernando. And so we kind of mentioned, you know, the reach that FISU already has, you know, with the sports events that they put on. I mean, also our national members, we're all tied in. But when we talk about something of this scale, I mean, we're talking 150, 180 million university students around the globe as a potential audience for something like this. So, I mean, this must really create a new opportunity to reach new, vast, and varied audience that nobody really has been able to capture that global community before. Is that one of the aims of the FISU Healthy Campus program?
Well, in the end, it could be, but the main target audience of this program for FISU are the universities. And universities will work, of course, directly with the students, and not only with the students, with the campus community and also with local community. We develop some programs inside the standard that university must cooperate mainly with the future students, the alumni. So there is a lot of programs that could reach not only the campus community, but also some targets, some stakeholders. Our goal is to involve more people. It will be a consequence of the program. If we together have more people involved, all of us will benefit. The university, our members, FISU, and the people, more people will be healthier and more prepared for the future. I would like to mention that our program is aligned also with the Sustainable Development Goals 2030. So we are here also to help to change the world to a better world with better people and healthier people. That's That's the big goal.
That sounds like some very good goals, very, very lofty goals for us all to achieve. So, but before we get into those goals and how are you going to achieve them, Fernando, you know, really get into the nuts and bolts of the program. I think both myself and the viewers, we want to know more about Fernando. We want to know more about, the man leading the charge of this. So, Fernando, how did you get your start in sports?
Well, I started to play basketball when I was 10, and then I started to play football when I was 12. I played these two sports at the same time until the 16, and then in competition I played more 6 years later football. But in school, I was always playing other sports like badminton, gymnastics, handball, volleyball. Well, when I was younger, I was really addicted to sport. I live close to the border of Spain, and they had many sport programs and games on TV. They had excellent programs on TV, and at that time it was really, really good for me to watch and to follow some role models and to be aware of what's going on in the world of sport. Well, today I watch I watch all the sports, because I like all the sports. And I play some football twice a week with some friends from FISU also and from other federations. And one time badminton, not bad. 3 times a week, organized sport. And then I have time to walk and to run a little bit.
Yeah, perfect.
Very good in the past.
And Fernando, so it sounded, obviously you started your love of sport very young. You've continued to do it through to today. But how was it when you went to the University of Porto in Portugal? What role did sports and physical activity play when you were a student at the university?
Well, in the university, in the sport faculty in Porto, we had many, many practical classes. In the morning, normally all dedicated to sport. But I had the time in the first and second year of the faculty to play futsal and football, representing the faculty. But from the third year, I start to be more motivated for the sport management area. Mm-hmm. A colleague who was the president of the students' union in my second year invited me to collaborate with the student union, and after 3 years, I was president, dealing with many issues, but university sport was always my priority. Well, and as university student later, I arrived at the board of the National University Sports Federation in Portugal, FADU.
Yeah, and in addition to working through the universities and University National Sports Federation for Portugal, you also were the vice president for Sporting Club Braga. So I'm definitely picking up on a theme. It's sports, it's university. What is it about, helping young emerging athletes, through sports that is so appealing for you?
Yeah, it's true. As you know, I've been since 1994 director for sports and culture in the Minho University. That is a university with two campuses, Braga and Guimarães. And in fact, in 2015, the president invited me to the board of Sporting of Braga. It's a big club in Portugal, to be vice president in a voluntary basis. And in 2019, I was working full-time for 1 year, just 1 year, for the professional area of the club, on the international project, also in dual career. And it was really good. And also giving a big hand to the other sports among football. We had there a very good project, a very good link with the schools and with the university. Of course, always focus in every athlete that they must succeed in sport and studies. But the project is really good. Not only with the university, don't work only with Sporting of Braga, but works also with many clubs, handball clubs in Braga and also in the other city in Guimarães. But in the Sporting of Braga, it was a fantastic experience that is working for many and many years, and putting all the effort in the succeed in sport and the studies and studies, sharing coaches, sharing facilities, sharing programs. It works really, really well. It's a good example.
So when you talk about that example, you know, in that sharing of resources, knowledge, this is something that's really important for the universities, as I understand, you know, so that, that they are part of this global community. One, you have these global experts that are really excited to learn from other people that are at the top of their games, but the universities themselves are going to learn from each other. Is that correct?
Yes, it's correct. It's correct. And it's one of the main issues of our project. I think if we learn from the others, some projects that that are succeeding, you can adapt and you can add value, you can innovate. So that's one of our issues. In our project, we integrate one of the experts from each university in the group of experts. We define a profile we define a profile for our experts from different areas, from international reference organizations with their relevant research and work, people who work directly with the universities providing services to the students, not only sport and physical activity, but health, mental health, psychological services, food service, nutrition, etc. And we organize this group at least to have two persons from the seven fields of each area of the project. And we submit the proposal to the president and to the secretary general. At least it was approved, we had now a very and good important work that is our standard based on seven domains: to know physical activity and sport, nutrition, disease prevention, mental and social health, risk behavior, environment, sustainability, and social responsibility. And there is one area that is cross-cutting, area-related, and integrate all the work of the university in the domain of FISU Healthy Campus.
Yeah, when you talk about innovating, you talk about having, you know, a great team. I mean, part of this starts with that group of experts, those 30 people that are helping you define those 100 criteria. Can you talk about how you selected those 30 experts? I imagine that was probably a rigorous and also difficult process to whittle down to only 30 of the foremost people in all those different seven areas that you spoke about.
Yeah, in the beginning, it was not easier, but as I mentioned, we tried to have at least one from the pilot universities because the approach is more radical. And then from the six core domains, we have two or three persons that come from international institutions like WHO, UNESCO, and people from the university or academic world, researchers in the different domains. And the group reached 32 of those experts. Two, unfortunately, was not possible to have two of the experts in our group. But in the end, the work that they have done was great. Was really great.
Yeah, and when we're talking about something, you know, as vast and as important as student health, I mean, we would be remiss if we did not mention, I mean, some of the really serious mental health challenges that students can face during the university years. I mean, what is it about this program that's going to help people that might be going through, you know, some very challenging times?
Time is challenging, but I think we have in our guidelines we have some criteria to develop all the areas. Of course, mental area is an issue, and we know that people can improve or can avoid mental diseases. Those results come from different studies that you can decrease like 50% of problems with mental health if you have a regular physical activity. So there is a lot of to do. There is a lot of programs to launch inside each university, and we have the guidelines to follow, of course.
Yeah, so it sounds like kind of sport is always kind of like the underlying theme, both with everything FISU does, and also, I mean, if you want to be a good student, you know, staying physically active is it also plays a component in that. When we talk about now, we're in a very special time with the global pandemic. I mean, universities, many universities, probably most, were shut down, you know, mid semester, and they've had to move to, you know, classroom time, to online courses instead of being in the classroom together. So I'd imagine that this makes a program like this so important for a time like now. So is this the ideal time to launch the FISU Healthy Campus program?
I think the time is good. I think the time is good to plan, at least make an evaluation of what the universities have been done, what has been already achieved, and to set some goals for the future. And the Healthy Campus could be a fantastic tool to help. For universities to start, don't have to be in a regular operation. Now, we know that universities in all over the world are closed, but they can register in the platform, and they can start to work, to evaluate what are the requests in each domain and planning, what they can do. We set 100 criteria. In the first year to be certified, you just need to reach 40 to be certified, and universities can plan in different years how to make the evaluation, how to progress in that in our program. So I think now there is an opportunity to launch the program in each university.
Yeah, and so what would you say? Maybe there's some university rector listening in right now, or some university student. What's the first step that that a university would need to take to become part of the program?
Well, I think for rectors and for universities, it's a huge opportunity to launch projects like Healthy Campus, because it involves all the schools of the services in one goal. So it's a common project for the universities. And normally we know that the universities, big universities with many faculties, sometimes it's difficult to put all the people together and to work for the same goal. So this is one point. And what I want to say to the universities and to directors is to feel that this is a really good opportunity to improve the well-being of all the campus community. The approach is to improve. The approach is, it's a little bit like the quality system management inside the university related to the well-being. They have facilities. They have professors that are experts in many fields. They have all the resources. You don't need the big resources to start this project. They just need to go to our platform, make the registration, and start to work.
Okay, and where do they find this this platform? Should they go to the FISU .net website? Is there somewhere else where you'd send them to?
Yeah, by the FISU website, there is a link to the platform. But the platform it will be open tomorrow officially at 2 p.m.
tomorrow.
To try to reach all the world at the same time. It's not easier to reach everybody because the difference of time, but tomorrow at 2 o'clock, 2 p.m. they can, the platform, it will be open, is ready. So it's a question of decisions to start to work.
Yeah, and we talk about opening this program. I mean, building something of this magnitude takes a team. So before we open this up for a question or two from the audience, do you have any notes of appreciation or you know, about the FISU Healthy Campus and University Relations team, that, you know, how did you guys work to make this be able to be a reality starting tomorrow at 2 p.m.?
Well, we have made our plans. We have some goals. We are prepared to respond to the demand. And if there are many universities that want to reach the program, we have our team now three persons full time to work on that. But of course, we have all the staff from FISU that is giving a hand, like marketing, like media. Everybody was involved on that program, education. And of course, we are ready to react. If the numbers are huge, we must improve our team. But I think we are prepared, at least for the first year, to have more than 100 universities until December. We can reply easily.
Yeah, that sounds like a really cool goal to reach triple digits with people with universities signing up in this first year. Fernando, I'm going to turn it over to the questions from our live audience. And okay. we have one. I think I'm going to pull it up on the screen. But they're asking, how high are the standards for universities to participate in, you know, in the Healthy Campus program?
Well, we design a program to be achievable for universities with many resources and huge resources, to small universities and to big universities. Of course, there are basic criteria that are not so difficult to achieve, but of course there are some more that are more complex and need more work to implement inside the university. But it's like always, when you start to when you go to a certification program, you have those kind of things. It's and the university can plan his work to start wherever they want. It's open. You don't need to reach one criteria to go to another. So there you have 100 criteria. You can start from the ones that don't take too much time, the ones that are already, because universities have already someone that is just to justify, is just to upload documents to the platform. And there are others that you need some work, of course. Yeah. That's why there is a different after the first year. On the second year, you have five different labels: certified, bronze, silver, gold, and platinum.
Okay, platinum's the highest, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Excellent. So we have one more question coming from one other question I want to share with you from the audience, Fernando. I'll pull it up on the screen, but they're wanting to know a little bit more about this platform, and is it only going to be available in English or other languages?
Well, for the moment, and until December, only in English. We will have always the demand, but we will translate the platform for other languages. But it will be not an issue to put the evidences in the platform, because if one university have documents of or videos or posters to put in the platform, they can put in their language, in French, in Chinese, in Russian. So we will accept those options, but the rules, the regulations, the standard, everything is in English. But we hope that in the future we'll translate for other language, because we already feel that at this moment we are receiving many feedbacks from countries like China, Russia, India. They have many universities, the French-speaking countries, and we must follow that tendency and to be more achievable for all the people that will work in the platform. But it's not an issue to put documents in other languages in the platform. So.
Yeah, perfect. So it sounds like 2020, like you said, not hard to put it into other languages. we'll look to add other languages as we sign up more universities. So so look forward to having many from India, Russia, China, Spain, and all the other countries of the nation. So Fernando, I mean, I don't want to take too much of your time, and you've really explained the platform. I'm excited to see this platform myself, 2 p.m. tomorrow, Switzerland time, 1 p.m. In London for our UK followers. But is there anything else, any final words you want to talk about, mention about why you're so excited about this program?
Well, as I mentioned before, we are really satisfied with this project. Is online with the FISU strategy. People are really motivated inside FISU to launch and to work more close with universities, more close with the national university sport federations. I think it's a great opportunity to all, and also to show to the world that universities can contribute more for sustainability and to have a better world. So we start tomorrow. We'll see. We are really confident that the project will be a big success. And if someone have questions, doubts, people can go to the FISU website, and it's not difficult to reach the contacts to send us questions, emails, to go to the platform. The platform, it will be really intuitive. It's really simple. We put it simple to work, not complex, really easy to understand. So be free to ask us things, to send us ideas, to share projects. Well, that's my message.
Yeah, and Fernando, if some people want to come reach out to the FISU Healthy Campus and University Relations team directly, what's the best way to do that? So we have the department email on the Healthy Campus page. Is there any other way that you would look that they could reach you and your team?
Yeah, tomorrow in the internet page of FISU, in the bar, you select Healthy Campus, and it will be easier to find our contact details, and you can send us email, and we can speak, no problem.
Okay. Well, Fernando, we're getting a lot of messages from people wishing you and FISU the best of luck with the Healthy Campus program. They're looking forward to engaging their universities, looking to use the program, looking to sign up other universities. So I think we're already off to a pretty solid start, even before kickoff. So,
well, just one information. We will schedule with our department meetings with the national university sports federations to work in a closer way and to explain more and in detail the project. So we'll contact by 15 days all the university sports federations, our members, to work together on the program.
Excellent, Fernando. Sounds like you've got about 180 phone calls coming up your way in the next 15 days. So with that, we'll let you get at it. Thank you so much for joining us. And we look forward to hearing from both from within FISU, how the program's going, and also more from your experts as throughout this this year.
Okay. Thank you, Torin, for your help. You were not so fast speaking. I hope that everybody understood the answers, and it was great. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you, Fernando.
Goodbye.